What's up, Jayden?
Hey, how are you doing?
I'm good. How's your well-being?
Well-being, I would say mentally I'm pretty good right now. I'm refreshed, got some good sleep too.
So okay.
Overall, I'm good mentally, so yeah.
Now, you and I met when I came to Deliver Food, and I was captivated by your passion.
Yes, sir.
You know, and you also took the time to like talk to me, and I took the time to listen. And so I felt like for you in particular, and you got everybody together, it was very important for your voice to be heard also.
Yes,
but just for, I know what you shared with me, just so everyone can know, how did you personally, or why did you personally get involved with the movement?
So for me, I'm a very spiritual person, so I felt called to be here. Even though freshman year, I had my own personal experience being in a dorm that had rodents, you know, roaches, flea-infested bathrooms and cold showers. So I had some bad experiences paying over $48,000 a year in a dorm. But this year, with those shared experiences, I saw a colleague of mine occupying a space who was coughing up blood, hospitalized because of mold in his freshman dorm. And so I was like, oh no, like for me to graduate and not address this will be, you know, a shame for me as a mature individual 3 years later not to be here. So I felt called because of personal experience as well as seeing my colleagues go through the same stuff 3 years later. Additionally, for me, I would say that this is passion for me for my career aspirations. You know, I plan on being a civil rights attorney, speaking up for those who are silenced or oppressed. And so right now I'm seeing my very colleagues be oppressed by Howard University administration when it comes to their concerns. The very reason why they occupied this space was because they had a town hall meeting at the town hall meeting requesting Howard admin to come up to the table and speak to answer their concerns, and they didn't show up. They were non-responsive. They were missing in action. And so here we are now, I guess 4 weeks later, and they still haven't responded to it. So I'm here to help them voice their concerns, be the advocate for change.
I'm glad that you kind of brought that up, because one of the big questions, especially among alumni and when people contact me, is why Blackburn? Why not the A building or other parts of campus? What makes Blackburn so significant to this movement?
I would say Blackburn is significant when factoring in strategy and the pandemic with COVID. So let's say that we were to entertain us taking over the A building, right? For a few days, they see the impact, but then it'll just directly impact possibly Howard administration to where they'll just do virtual work from home. And so it wouldn't really make as much noise as Blackburn would have. Blackburn is the biggest cafeteria on campus, you know? A lot of kids go here, and by us stopping the flow of like the regular business for Howard administration, it got Howard faculty, their attention, as well as student attention as well. Now, it didn't really have a negative effect on students because we're still feeding them. We're still feeding them and giving them mutual aid supplies, but this made some noise, critical noise, that's historic, rather, compared to us doing it in a building. So I think, given in light of the COVID pandemic, this was the best term strategy.
Now, what would make Jada satisfied of a good outcome for you? What would help you feel good?
I would feel good graduating in May knowing that, one, the demands were met, knowing that they would reinstate or have new dorms for campus. I heard the stories of Meridian Hill or Meridian Hall, Carver Hall, other halls that were...
I'm a Carver boy.
Carver.
Keep going.
Yeah. Knowing that there were other residence dorms that were closed down, but my thing is you're closing down dorms or you're selling them out to outsourcing them, but you're not replacing them for incoming classes. So I want to see new, fresh dorms being built or like replaced with what's currently in store or currently in the proximity of campus. And I also want to make sure that all the demands were met, that the alumni, faculty, affiliate positions for students are reinstated for the Board of Trustees, and to also see that the people who currently oversaw Howard administration this past year are in the right direction of resigning, honestly. Because the fact that, like, when you look at the moral aspect of this whole protest, the whole sit-in and the whole ordeal, the fact that you allowed over 150 students occupying this space for 28 days, sleeping in the cold, shutting off Wi-Fi, power, internet, and being non-responsive to our concerns, and you going to bed at night thinking it's okay, that really does not sit well with me at all. As in, even if they met the demands, the fact that they would trickle over to the next school year still being in their positions, I'm not okay with that at all, because what were you going to do for the next case who bring concerns to you? You're going to try and threaten them, bring officers in to threaten to, you know, assault them. You know, like, the way that you handled this is not okay with me.
Yeah, I mean, because that is the narrative that's trying to be spent, is that the demands have been met, and the attitude and narrative that I've been seeing is, you know, being ungrateful, and, you know, they're just trying to do all of this other stuff and everything. I mean, your feelings to that is what? When you hear those kind of things, how do you make you feel being here?
It makes me feel as if in a black institution with black officials, they're tone policing black students who are thriving in excellence. You know, you're characterizing us as chaotic, you know, damaging, disrespectful, when all we're doing is bringing attention in a professional manner what the issues are.
So, Jayden, if you can tell me, what personally would you like to see the outcome of this movement? Like, what would work for you?
Walking away from this movement, I want to see first that how our administration is being held accountable. You know, that they meet all four of our demands. And I also want more than that, too. I want to walk away in May knowing that the people who oversaw the decisions over this whole protest, they resigned. Because it's just also me sitting here with other people sleeping on concrete for over 28 days, and it's them not responding and them going to bed and being okay with it. So it's more of like people here in this building, we're sacrificing a lot. Law school applications delayed, you know, classes dropping 2-letter grades because they're cutting off Wi-Fi, you know, the water in some of the bathrooms, having us in below 50 degree weather inside the building and saying the heat's on. Like, they've been doing everything in their power to retaliate for us voicing our concerns. And that was all on their watch. So after meeting our demands, I just respectfully hope that they resign.
Yeah, I got to tell you, that hits. That really does. I mean, how do you feel about certain narratives? What's the one thing that you can say that's not being said out there that we can hear?
So I know for a fact that the opposing side, Howard administration, they've been characterizing us as chaotic, dangerous, disrespectful. But I just want the world to know that, like, we're thriving in Black excellence here. We're the next future social activists. We're the next people who are going to be key stakeholders in our community, basically advocating for change, being change agents. And so all we're doing is advocating for better housing, our rights being reinstated. And so I just want them to know that we're not communicating all this in a disrespectful way at all. We're just advocating for the love of Howard, show them that we are activists, but we also are acting out of love for Howard, too.
Okay. Now, what's the singular place that everyone can go for information to read the demands, know the updates and everything like that?
Right now, our central location on Instagram and Twitter is the Live Movement _ the Live Movement, THELIVEMOVEMENT.
Okay. I appreciate that. I mean, Thank you. This is your senior year.
Yes, sir.
And you looking out for kids, students that are younger than you and everything. I can't wait to see what you're going to thrive to be.
Thank you.
I mean, what's that? What's your major again?
I'm a legal communications major with a minor in political science.
Your resume is already half as bad as mine. I appreciate you, Jaden. Thank you for everything.
Much respect.
Jaden, we back.
Yes,
how you feel?
I feel refreshed, well rested.
Okay.
You know, glad that the outcome was what it was. I feel really good. I feel content with myself right now and the other protesters.
Last time we was here, we had no idea how things were going to turn out or how long they were going to be. What kept you motivated for 34 days of protesting?
Honestly, in times when I feel like I lost myself, I would say that it was my personal experiences with Howard alongside the stories of my co-protesters. You know, some of them, they really had nowhere else to go. So if we were to leave with nothing or just to leave empty-handed, they would have to go back to moldy dorms, mushrooms and stuff. And so I also remember that this isn't just about me, it's also about the current students and the future bison that are to come in the next generation and next school year. So I had to think to myself, this isn't just about me being selfish and being tired and being weary of what Howard may do to me as a graduating senior. I had to think about the other people beside me and people coming behind me as well.
But be that as it may, you glad that it's over?
I'm glad that it's over. I'm thrilled.
You look way more rested than the last time we saw each other, but you wore like war ready.
Yes.
So it's good that the students were a motivation for you because it was more about future students for you, what we talked about last time.
Right.
Now, I saw on the Live Movement IG that you can't go into details about the agreement, right?
Yeah.
Now, I gotta imagine transparency is something that the Live Movement wanted. So this is me saying, I'm pretty sure the agreement to keep everything confidential, I'm just guessing it didn't come from you guys or whatever, and I understand you can't go into details, but is there a way that students and people who support alumni can know about the agreement? Like, is it gonna be updates or something like that of that nature?
First and foremost, I can say to follow the Live Movement, the Live Movement, for updates. And then also, if you really wanna see what Howard administration plans to do post his occupation and his demonstration within the Blackburn University Center, look at what Howard University does in the coming months, their actions that they take, that we were requesting that they do. That's the best way that we can put it. We can't really go into detail with the agreement. We signed an NDA, as you put it. But just also know that from our standpoint, from our perspective, we lived and breathed the mantra that we keep us safe and that we are here for the people, for the students at Howard. So we want to share information, but we just can't right now. But you'll see soon.
Okay.
What we plan to put into
so
practice.
So you're satisfied?
We won. I'm satisfied.
Okay.
We won.
Okay. What happens now?
What happens now? We have to keep going. The marathon continues, you know? I think that we did a good job in showing the world throughout this 34-day occupation, that Howard University chose to cut corners. And now it's time for them to choose the consequences that come with those cutting corners. So I think we just have to really keep on their neck and apply pressure, to continue to apply pressure to make sure that they know that this wasn't the end of us basically holding them accountable with their injustice and their lack of action with the housing conditions, with the Board of Trustees, with regard to using scare tactics and whatever, retaliation at a university where they acknowledge that we're here to be future leaders and key stakeholders, you know? Just basically applying pressure regardless, whatever it takes. 10 toes down.
And thank you for correcting me. It's the Live Movement, and I've been following their updates religiously. Just before we go, explain that first moment you felt, or that emotion you felt when everything was done.
I felt like a weight lifted off my shoulder. Honestly, my heart skipped 2 beats. It did. Because the way that it was going, it was just, you didn't know what else it would take. I mean, you had Yana Presley, Cori Bush, Senator Elizabeth Warren. You had other politicians applying pressure, different pressure points. And we had the alum come down the previous weekend, that same weekend. And we were like, well, dang, what will it take for them to actually give in and actually, you know, meet with us? Our demands weren't demanding. And so to see that they finally caved in on day 34, a week before Thanksgiving, 2 weeks before Thanksgiving, rather, it was honestly a relief. It was, I was glad to see that they ended the chaos.
Three, 2, 1. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm happy for you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you for putting this together. Thank you for everything. And it feels good to see that the school is in good hands.
Yeah.
So just thank you very much, and I wish you a great journey. And please keep in touch. You know,
thank you. And thank you for being willing to share our story, too.
Always. Appreciate you. Stay safe.